Welcome back, everybody, for another episode of Magic 2015, the game where I'm a Jedi and also have training electric balls that I shoot with Illuminati lasers. I don't know. Rob is making up shit, and that's I'm just going to run up with.
Look at Nick's dude, right? Like, how is he not a Jedi, right? He's got all those training balls where they shoot lasers at him. He's even wearing the helmet to guard his eyes. Like, he just needs a lightsaber, and then he's good. Like, Obi-Wan can teach him the ways of the Force and stuff. Like, he's ready.
He looks like Hawkeye underneath that weird fan thing.
He does. I can see that, yeah.
These are nerds.
He's got the eagle eye thing going on.
Does he have, like, a scar on his chest? Because I know, I see the text.
Illuminati.
No, I see that, but, like, what's the little black stripes there?
That's the dingy shit coming off the UI, man.
Yeah. It's gritty realism. That dirty, it just kind of flows around.
It's elegant diamonds and gritty realism. That's what we make.
Yeah. Ugh.
I guess I'll be ready now. I don't know.
Yeah, ready. Yeah, that sounds good.
I decided to take
there's a bone wizard, and he's got a bunch of anal beads hanging off a staff in my loading.
I saw the bone wizard, yeah. I didn't know if we get the same dude every time, actually.
I don't think we do, actually, but did I lose? I don't know.
Let's just all say we lost, and then somebody
we lost.
Lost.
Keep.
I'm fucking lost.
I feel like I won.
That's pretty good. All right, that's good.
I kept a bad hand. It's bad.
Yeah, I kept a potentially really bad hand as well, but
Bat hand.
I kept a bat hand, yeah.
You have a bat hand?
Mm-hmm. Elixir of immortality.
Elixir of mortality.
It's good for me. It doesn't really do much at this point in the game. It would be better if I had stuff in my graveyard, but it's there.
Oh, damn. Pretty good. Yeah,
I'm going to guess nobody can get rid of it, right?
Well... Wait, is it an artifact? Yeah, I don't know if we have artifact killers. I don't know. Maybe Rob's card does that too. Kills enchantments and artifacts. I don't fucking know.
Yeah, it could be.
I'm not going to make a massive difference. I was just kind of curious.
Who are going to make a massive difference?
Why are you doing a Jamaican accent?
Yeah, it kind of sounded like he
started Italian when Jamaican, I guess.
Yeah, that was like Avsies.
Snakes kind of sounded a little bit Jamaican, and that's why I thought, like, who are going to make a.
It's not Jamaican at all.
Good. Oh, why?
Why?
I don't know, man.
Just a 1-1.
It's the one that actually doesn't do anything.
Yeah, he's literally
This fucking game right now is a joke.
Get Russet Wolves?
Yeah, I have all of my cards are Russet Wolves.
Oh, I should have used it on that guy.
Yeah!
Oh, no.
Yeah, it doesn't do anything for you. Actually, here's another reason you shouldn't have done it. Because I just got another one.
Oh, no. Whoa.
He's dangerous, man. He's a 1-1
that lost
on the board.
What am I going to do?
I don't know, man.
Keep rolling?
Keep rolling.
That's enough rolling.
No more rolling. We're done with rolling.
We're done.
Hey, you had news topics to discuss, by the way. So let's we should go to the news topics. Are you gonna fucking? I fucking hate you so much.
Honestly, that was just completely to spite you, not for any actual reason. Because obviously, the Austin card there was much more threatening.
I lost, actually, though.
Fucking piece of shit. I
could be gaining 4 life per turn right now.
Yeah, he's about
to. That's true, but I'm going to play the passive guy this turn. I'm not going to make anyone mad.
Wow.
Yeah, I'm changing my ways, man. I'm usually the first to attack, but now I'm just not going to attack ever.
Cool.
All right.
I'll be the guy that impulsively attacks everyone for no reason, and Austin will be me. And who does that leave left? I guess Rob just says I lost a lot. I don't know.
Really not count? Oh, because it's not a fucking basic god piece of shit garbage. Whatever.
Well, you lost.
You don't have a basic land card. You have an especially complex gate.
Is it gate?
I got one of those gates.
There's other things than gates, though.
Yeah, but I think he doesn't have anything.
I mean, my whole plan, like, there was no reason to do it in that order, but my plan was like, hey, this motherfucker's gonna tap anyway, whatever, I can just fucking play it, but now I can't, so fuck me, I guess.
Yeah, that
sucks. Yeah, I guess.
Grave Digger.
We don't have anything to bring back, so I'm just putting him out so you guys don't kill me.
Right, so if I could get a land, that'd be stellar, thank you.
As far as my news topics go, I really just kind of wanted to talk about the PlayStation experience and the misbranding nightmare that I feel that they've fallen into by doing this thing. All right, fair enough.
I changed my mind, I'm sorry.
Yeah, no, I wish you'd stick with the persona you decided to randomly come up with. But
I couldn't maintain it for longer than one turn. It was actually eating me out from the inside.
It was eating you out?
Yeah.
There's one word you never put after eating, unless you mean a very specific type of eating. That's the one. You found it.
It was eating you out, yeah. Sometimes that happens, man. I've been there.
From the inside out.
Sometimes you just get eaten out, yeah.
From the inside.
You just get eaten out.
Well, it's like a tapeworm who's actually kind of a good guy. Doing you a favor.
Tapeworm who's actually kind of a good guy.
Nick, does your card deck have anything that's not a kill card?
They're mostly kill cards.
That's good to know.
You should have some counter spells, maybe.
No, I'm a god.
I don't think anyone has counter spells.
Counters are noobs. That's true. But yeah, so wait, what did they even talk about in the PlayStation press conference?
First of all, why do they even do one is the first question. I'm going to guess it had something to do with the 20-year anniversary of PlayStation brand. Austin, feel free to back me up here because I didn't actually watch most of the actual conference. I just caught the post stuff.
I caught like the last half of it. It was, yeah, they were just kind of celebrating as much like celebratory 20 years of PlayStation nonsense. And I was like, all right, I get it. But
it's like an excuse for them to run commercials, right?
It was just like they advertised a bunch of games. Why can't I have any nice things? They advertised a bunch of games that like, I wasn't even attacking you, Rob, that like, I lost my train of thought because fuck you. Okay, cool. I actually hate you.
What, you had the fucking light? I want to get rid of Nimbus Wings.
Okay, you didn't have to attack me afterwards, though, to rub it in.
Well, you also have 26 fucking... You still have more health than the starting thing. And we remember last game when you had fucking 8 million billion health.
Game that I lost?
Well, yeah, but still.
Anyway, they showed, I think, like one new game. It might have been two. I didn't see the beginning half. But the one game was like... It seemed like a really lazy, like it was their big final, you know, last game to show thing. And it was, I don't even remember, like Drawn to Death or something like that.
Well, they certainly advertised Drawn to Death a lot, but they also made a big fuss about the, Final Fantasy VII coming to PlayStation 4, not as a new version, but as a port. Like, okay.
Yeah, they made a lot of excitement about it. It was really strange.
They got the crowd all looped up and like excited, and then they're like, actually it's that thing you could already have bought for a lot of years.
Yeah. It was weird. But
played on an emulator.
Right.
Yeah, the Drawn to Death thing was like didn't even look like anything special.
It looks like an angsty teenager's drawings that are like in a deathmatch game. I don't know.
It's like, yeah, it just kind of looked like anything. It looked like a Borderlands-y multiplayer with a kind of okay aesthetic. And then all the rest of the games they showed off were just games that are already we know about.
Right.
It was weird. It was really a weird conference.
But that's what I wanted to question was the relevance of even doing this whole thing. Like, I don't really understand what the point was. It seemed like most people believed this was like their answer to doing two per year of the E3 conference, where they're going to reveal a bunch of new things and talk about the year ahead, which would actually make sense since we're about to go to the new year, and this is like just after the big holiday sales season. So you'd think, all right, so what are we going to get hyped for next year's big holiday sales season? And, well, all the stuff we already knew about, apparently.
Yeah, I mean, they were hyping up like the Vita. They were like, oh, you guys thought we forgot about the Vita. Oh, we actually have 7 games coming out, and like 6 of them are games that are already out. And 2 of them are games that came out like 20 years ago. What the fuck is wrong with you guys?
You're the only one that would have made a big difference there.
I actually only attacked you with one creature to get you down to 20 life.
I appreciated I did appreciate that.
Yeah, it was just so that you could be at even keel with all of us. We're all at 20 life. Well, now you have Angelic fucking Accord, so...
And no creatures to do anything with.
Yeah, you get the one lone missionary and you get a 4/4 flying angel piece of shit.
Alright, so we were right to do what we did.
Yes.
So the question after that I was thinking is they started doing all these really weird developer interviews with, I saw one when they did with Destiny's producer. They had this long protracted weird thing with Blizzard about Diablo 3. And I saw, like, Tearaway had one, No Man's Sky, and they had, like, the worst people doing the interviews, and also when the developers did them themselves, the production values were abysmal. So my question is, how does an industry leader like Sony still exist to this point and has such a terrible sense of how to put on a show where every single time they cut back to the people doing the interviews, their mics are out for 30 seconds, or they show a trailer and it's the wrong size resolution, or there's just music playing over top everyone so no one can hear anything. Like, how do you get to this level, but you also can't even produce something like on the level that we do on our streams?
Well, there, I think there are a lot of things that factor into that, though. Like, because no matter what, like, if you're doing a live event, shit can always go wrong. Like, always. Yeah, there you go. 4-4 Angel Flyer piece of shit.
It's only, but anyway. It's only one.
Yeah, but anyway, so, like, if you... Okay, yeah. You see what I'm fucking saying?
Oh, wait, no, I'm an idiot. Actually, oh, wait, that only gives me one still, though. I'm stupid.
Oh, really? Why?
Because it's at the end of the turn.
You don't get all the life, though? You still get all the life back.
I get the life, so I guess life, that's okay. Yeah. But yeah, I'm stupid.
Yeah.
Anyway, continue.
Yeah, so what was that? What was I saying?
You're making excuses that they can still have problems.
Because like, because you could look at something like the Super Bowl, which has 110 million viewers, the most of any television thing, anytime, anywhere, right? Like, 2 years ago, the whole stadium fucking died in power, and like, right. A live event, no matter what you do, it can always get fucked up somehow. And then secondarily, too, it's like, I don't know where they did this. Like, where did they do this? This thing was put on a stage. Okay, yeah. So like, they probably couldn't rent it out. They probably had like one dress rehearsal, because you can't rent it out more time than you have, you know. So
sure.
It's so they.
It was just weird. Like, we're so used to like it was so nice like 5 years ago, maybe it was even six. Like when the E3s were like everyone was like, oh shit, E3 is coming. This is gonna be awesome. They're gonna announce all these new cool games. It's gonna be so exciting. Now, Nintendo doesn't even do E3. They do their own thing. Sony and Microsoft just like, oh, buy a Kinect. Fucking.
That's the news topic that I wanted to talk about, though, is they showed footage, the first footage of Zelda.
Oh, I was gonna say that.
Well, let's get to that after. I wanted to say another few things about it. So the whole weird show. What I wanted to say is that I think it's an exercise in missed branding opportunities here, because what they're doing is they're billing this as sort of like an E3 conference and getting all the people that are revved up about new announcements. Then they go on to not deliver those announcements. They do it in front of a Twitch audience who are all talking shit the entire time, and it ultimately never goes anywhere, and they culminate this after the show's over with a bunch of interviews with developers talking about VR and talking about the future of the industry and talking about development processes, and the whole time the Twitch chat's going, this is bullshit, this is boring, we're not gonna show us shit. And then they show a bunch of commercials, and the commercials are for stuff that's not even out yet, and they're trying to sell you DLC. And it's like a big orgy of fucking consumerist everything with no payoff. So I don't understand how that's a good idea for them in any direction. They're basically pissing off and alienating everybody by even doing this. If they're going to do something like this, it could be cool, but don't do it in front of Twitch with the expectation that this is going to be like E3.
Yeah.
I don't think the audience gets the difference.
Like 140,000 like people or something? Oh, there it goes. Ascended to heaven.
I actually fucked up because I wasn't paying attention, but I could have stopped the damage too, but I'm an asshole.
I kept watching in the Twitch chat, people kept saying, so, like, you're losing viewers, guys, you've dropped from 29,000 to 23,000, and then I kept being like, so, like, Sony is a Twitch channel now? Do they care about the viewers? They're not here to do viewership.
Well, that was after the whole presentation, too, wasn't it?
Yeah, that was at the end. That was after the thing had ended.
But yeah, even the presentation itself was just, like, really boring. All stuff we've seen before. There was like no reason to have this conference at all. There was just actually no reason.
So I'm trying to understand what the point of it even is. Like, why did it happen?
I don't know. That's a good question. I actually don't know. I don't know if they were trying to like ride off the Game Awards that was the night before hype or anything. Which we have to talk about some of the nominations because it's actually hilarious.
Yeah, I didn't see any of it.
I didn't care, yeah, because I knew that
there
was
going to
happen.
There was a best remake category I saw on Twitter.
There was a best remake category. Yep, that's the one thing. You want to hear what was nominated for best action-adventure game?
What?
Assassin's Creed Unity.
Okay. Yeah,
how'd they come up with that one?
That game that totally works.
Yeah, you want to, on the same vein, Developer of the Year nomination? Ubisoft.
Okay, yeah.
Nomination. Well, I mean, there's like five developers that exist in the AAA space, right? So they're going to get nominated.
Yeah. That's why, like, someone asked me too yesterday if I was going to watch. Why did you fuck me, Nick, with the flying guy? I don't get it.
No. Just a wild card. Like, I'm like Josh today. I'm just going to do stuff.
I guess so. Oh, and I fucked up really bad. Whatever. Fine.
I'm here to talk about shit, not to play Magic. Ha! Fuck you, commenters.
Yeah. But,
wild card.
Yeah, wild card bitches.
Not really, fuck you, commenters.
Honestly, I'm okay with that switcheroo because, like, that's, like, the least threatening switcheroo you've done to me over the course of all switcheroos.
But, someone was asking me, someone was asking me about whether I'd watch the Game Awards, and it's like, why would I? Like, they're not going to even look at indie games.
I guess we're
going
to transition we're going to transition here into the Zelda news, but I was like, Game Awards, like, who the fuck, why would, we're not going
to. Yeah, and then I saw it, like, marketed on all these news websites, which is like, why are they marketing some random ass fucking thing? But they were, but anyway, and they were marketing as, like, the first ever Game Awards. Like, what are you talking about, the first ever Game Awards?
There have been years of
headlines on Polygon, first ever Game Awards tonight, don't miss it. Like, how much do you guys get paid to fucking market that shit?
You know, they're saying Game Awards is the variable. That's just the title of the thing. They're not saying this is
the first. No, I know.
Okay.
But the way that it's phrased specifically is made to be confusing. You can admit that, right? Like, it's called the Game Awards.
Yeah, yeah. If you're going to do yellow journalism about it, then that's a really strange way to slant the headline. I understand that.
Yeah, exactly. So it's like, I don't give a shit because I've seen the DICE Awards. They were awful. The Spike Awards, equally awful. Like, they don't look at indie games at all. They're not looking at games. They're looking at, hey, let's do an echo chamber circle jerk here for the AAA games.
AAA cock suck off, basically. Yeah, exactly. Which can we suck the best?
Yeah, and that's about what it was. But then I think we were playing Dota, and so we were devoid of any contact with any human being besides us. And I get on Twitter right before I'm about to go to bed, and I see all these people freaking out. Zelda's the new Zelda gameplay. I'm like, no. Yeah. I need to see this 10 minutes ago. I need to see this.
Can we admit that Halo Master Chief Collection won best multiplayer? Please tell me that happened.
Did it really?
No, I just wanted to have happened.
Hilarious. That would have been actually hilarious. No, but fucking, like, sure enough, Nintendo was like, all right, we're going to show like 4 minutes of Zelda gameplay footage, and it was amazing.
It
looked really fucking cool, though. And they explicitly said, like, this is coming out next year. Like, they even like made the joke that, are you sure this doesn't, like, is this gonna come out this year? And he said, absolutely.
Well, I mean, Twilight Princess happened, right?
And that's why, though, like, I'm really scared, is because that looked extremely ridiculously early, and if that looks really early and it's supposed to come out next year, we either have a Wind Waker situation on our hands. Well, or it's going to be delayed, which I would prefer it be delayed, honestly.
But when you say it's early, you can't really prove that it was early. They didn't show anything besides a landscape. They just went from one point to another, and they showed the map.
Yeah, I know. Enemies and things. So the things you have to realize, though, is that they didn't show my fucking dick in your ass.
Okay.
I don't know why they would have shown that.
I know, it's a little bit weird. I don't know why they would show that either, but they definitely didn't show it, so.
It's called a non sequitur for Nintendo at that point.
A bit, yeah.
It's just stealing my cards now.
Yeah. But, anyway, so, what was I saying?
You're telling us the things that they didn't show.
Okay, so firstly, the thing wasn't even on the main screen, right? It was a recording of a television next to Miyamoto and Aonuma. The reason that that was that way is because the art didn't look anywhere near good enough at that point. And you could even tell that the art didn't look anywhere near good enough because he was walking past this grass that was just like 2D wavy bullshit, and like there was nothing in the world in the environment, and they cut around through different things. There's like nothing in the world yet. They even just put the thing that they were saying is like, hey, horses don't run into trees by themselves. That's something that we're working on right now. It's like, that's what you're gonna show in the new Zelda. The horse doesn't run into fucking trees. They are so far from finished in that
game.
Dude,
that's like right up there with the new Call of Duty fish avoiding technology. That's pretty good shit, though.
Yeah, it is.
Fish doesn't clip through you, hopefully. They got that out of the Mario 64 technology, actually.
I think we lost.
No, you're stealing all my cards. What do you mean we lost?
Well, because you're gonna lose. Well, he's gonna do a lot of damage in a second here.
No, why? I don't have enough land for that. I just gave it lifelink.
Yeah. I don't know about that.
So the things that I'm thinking when I hear about new Zelda footage is I'm reminded of things like that the God of War 2 trailer took 6 months of development time to make a trailer before they even started building assets for the actual video game. Development cycles these days are longer than ever, but are being crunched to shorter than ever, which is resulting in what we've seen this holiday season is basically like the unfinished game holocaust of 2014. Everything is released broken. And right. I don't think that Nintendo is any way out of that cycle. I think they're just as susceptible to it as everyone else, regardless of the image that they want to put forward, that they're untarnished. I think they're very much vulnerable.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Oh, you're getting rid of it. Yeah, or are you stealing it?
I just don't get any cards. It just takes them all. I'm taking three of my cards.
Oh, weird guy.
You don't need those cards. I'm fucking dead if I didn't do that, though. Pretty butts. Yeah, Nintendo's still in a bad place, and I think it is kind of scary that they're showing off such an unfinished Zelda as, like, their thing. Okay, yeah.
Why would you... He can't use it, Nick. It was actually just a 2-2.
Oh, I don't know. Maybe he'll get it back somehow.
Well...
I'm a wild card, Austin.
Wild card!
When he steals your scavenger, Drake, how much of a wild card are you going to be?
I'll probably attack you then. Wild card!
Okay. Wild card, bitches. I cut the brakes! Woo!
I'm like the Joker. You can't tell what I'm going to do next.
I really hope I draw another fucking Discopa Guildmage just to fuck with you.
Okay.
I draw another land.
I knew this was coming. This actually sucks.
So I didn't actually see the Zelda footage, so he just runs around for a while and that's it? Or
yeah. The point they were making was how big the world was in this.
They were, yeah. The map looked rather big, admittedly.
Okay. I mean,
it looks freaking massive.
In
it
the No
like...
Man's Sky trailer, they made the point of how big that world is, too, but we all know it's going to be fairly empty.
I saw someone on Twitter actually getting mad at them, too. Well, yeah, that's that over that, where it's like, Miyamoto's like, oh, how long will it take for us to get to that tower? And Anuma's like, well, it's actually still going to take about 4 or 5 minutes.
Because maybe Link will get a different vehicle, right, instead of a horse.
Yeah, that'd be good. Yeah,
I thought they teased that, actually. I thought that was a thing.
Oh, that'd be cool. But, no, so, I saw someone on Twitter being like, no, I want a smaller, densely populated world instead of a large, expansive world. And it's like, I don't know, man, like, firstly, like, kind of, I don't really care. And then also, that's what every Zelda has been anyway, and they're trying to do something different, so don't, like, you know, fuck with them on them trying to...
I want a larger, more densely populated world.
Me too. I want a more densely populated, large world as well, but, you know...
I want Legend of Zelda nuts and bolts. I want to be able to build vehicles out of the trees that I chopped down by punching the trees down with my fist.
Oh, God. The,
Customize your own Zelda avatar that follows you over your head and says, Link, come on. You could buy the amiibo statues and put them on your... Okay, I've gone too far. What's all this about? Plant hydras, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Revealing cards, huh? Okay. Card boys.
Oh, that was... Ow! I fucking banged my knee.
Did you ask if
that was acceptable?
If your knee was okay with that? Yeah, because it's a little bit fucked up. I said, did you ask if your knee was okay with that?
What are you talking
Getting
about?
Getting banged out by you.
You're banging your
knee. Oh, what? You guys are fucking nerds. That was... I actually just didn't get... I wasn't
I have
there.
Been there, too.
Yeah.
So what's the answer to our endless negative Nintendo circle jerk? Would the answer have been for them to just wait?
Fuck that. I'm still excited. I feel like...
I'm excited for it. I'm glad that I saw footage.
Because it looked completely... The art style looked really different, and it looked really beautiful from what we could see.
It looks nice, yeah.
I feel like we're going to get a really good look at this at Nintendo's E3 event on what we're going to get.
I really dislike the aiming the bow with the stupid gamepad, though.
Like, I'm really hoping they just like have an option to...
Oh, Nick.
Why?
You've just made Austin win.
My 1-3 death touch wins?
Yeah.
Does it, though?
Yeah.
Nah.
How?
It doesn't. I have a death touch, too.
Yeah.
It's okay. True.
I would the land comparison here is actually very frightening. I'm happy I've been able to
five
do
lands.
How
yeah.
did you pull that off, man?
Yeah, really.
Have you been avoiding them? Like you see one, you're like discard that hand.
Yeah, get rid of the land.
There's no way you have
that. All right. Yeah, we lost though.
I'm really hoping you don't have another switcheroo.
Yeah. Well,
I'm done. I'm done. I'm fucking done.
Oh wow.
Like, what is the point? What's actually the point, though, of this game? What is the point of playing this game?
Hey, does Death Touch still kill stuff with First Strike?
No. It doesn't touch it.
Yeah.
That's bullshit.
Also, yours is, what, you're a Drake.
I'm not saying I have it right now. I'm just saying if I did have it.
Yeah, no, yeah. It wouldn't do anything.
It does not.
Like, what is the point of playing this game? Actually, though, I play any card that gets killed or stolen, and then I can't do anything. You're gonna switch through this. You drew it, didn't you? You drew it.
You should switch. No, I actually had it for a while.
Why wouldn't you take his freaking Scavenger Drake?
Because I don't need to take a Scavenger Drake yet. I waited until I had something like that to have, which is way more valuable.
You big old chump pies. Nobody's got anything good here for me to exile.
Are you actually serious, though?
Why?
Because he has a Baneslayer Angel. I mean, huh? That's pretty good to exile.
No, you don't understand what I'm saying. I'm talking about my worm.
Oh.
No.
Oh, okay.
It's a different story.
Yeah, you gotta be more specific, man. You know, yeah.
I actually drew all three royal switcheroos in this game.
That's cool.
Alright.
Just in case, I guess.
No, it's because I'm gonna get the health somehow. I'm gonna pick something.
No, I know, but everything had two.
You guys really hate my royal elemental, don't you?
Bullshit. I wish I could exile all your switcheroo cards at the beginning of the game.
I wish I could exile your entire fucking deck.
Your graveyard is literally three switcheroos right now.
I know.
It's actually your graveyard.
Three switcheroos on top. Well, and then my fucking two poor elvish visionaries that got two kill cards in the early game. These poor elvish. They just wanted to give vision. They're just vision granters. They're granters of vision.
Does a Drake count as a dragon?
That's what I don't think so. I think it actually has to say dragon.
Yeah, it has to say dragon.
So if that guy was like, started from the bottom, now we're here, it'd be like, no, yeah. Attacks go through.
Not a dragon, yeah.
Okay. Wild card.
Drew all four of my lone mysteries this game. Besides lands. Still no lands.
Well.
Hmm.
I don't know what to do, man. All of these actually don't matter because of the... Wait.
I don't know why they wouldn't matter.
Well, yeah, no, actually, they don't matter.
What's this about?
Yeah, now he's copying it. All right, cool.
Oh, man.
Now they actually don't
matter.
That's
awesome.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
What a player.
And you guys hate my deck.
Yeah.
Dude, I have 8 health. You have 27. What are you talking about?
Mine kills you, but at least it's not fucking obnoxious.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's not annoying.
Annoying. The deck that kills all four players at once without attacking anyone.
It's just real aggressive. It doesn't kill you.
Yeah, okay.
I mean, it does kill you. It doesn't annoy you, though.
It's very annoying.
It's very upfront about how it kills you. It does it very, very obviously.
Hmm. Yeah, it's bullshit.
You don't let me kill you. You just take my things, and then it's not fun.
Yeah, that's good. Yeah, I know. You should choose a different deck.
No, people do want me to change my deck, but I honestly this game doesn't exist to me until we need to record it.
You can do it like between episodes. Just use one of the pre-mades. That's what I did. That's what this is.
Oh my god, a fucking land! I still can't do anything. But holy shit, that's crazy. Okay,
you got a land.
You have any switcheroos?
That's good. Boy.
Probably should have played. I was gonna play that first, but I really just wanted the fucking angel. Well,
I can't believe I have like 4 decks or something, and you only have the one. You're way more into magic than I am. I think even.
I'm not really into magic. No. I mean, no.
I wouldn't say you're missing.
Yeah, I fucking hate magic.
I actually really hate it.
really picked the wrong game here to do 150 episodes of.
Yeah, really.
This could have been a Dota series.
Yeah, and then we'd have like 5 people watching that. Game is hard.
Game's real hard.
Nah, game's fine.
Is it?
Game's fine, yeah. You got any other new stuff to talk about? Any other shows that happened or awards to give away?
And give the award for worst award show.
I want an award show that actually handles like the gaming industry, not just like AAA console circle jerk. Like what game made the most money? That's what wins the award.
I mean, that's kind of how actors work, isn't it?
Yeah, it's how the Oscars are as well.
So why would it be any different?
I like that the one indie game that they chose to even have is Mountain.
That is an what? Interesting decision if that's the case.
It is weird. Like I don't.
That's one of the most esoteric indie games that exists. Yeah. It literally has no play function at all.
It's very strange.
You just watch it, and a banana will fall out of the sky and land on your mountain. Sometimes it tells you poetry every so often.
Yeah. Real weird.
Ow. Shit.
It's like they have to, you know, extend the olive branch to say that they still acknowledge that games that aren't in their sphere exist, but they just pick one or two as poster children for it. It seems like No Man's Sky is that lately, which reasonably, it kind of does bridge the gap a little bit between indie and AAA. It definitely has the production value feeling of a AAA game. We have yet to see if it turns out to be a Starbound when it comes out, though, but I hope it doesn't.
Yeah.
I hope it turns out to be awesome.
I hope it does, too, because it would be wonderful if it was awesome.
I'd also love to play that with Oculus Rift. It looks like it would be excellent for...
Oh, yeah, that'd be great. I'm really kind of scared, though. Like, not that I'm like, you know, against the developers or anything, but, like, this is easily their most ambitious title, because they're the guys who did the Joe Danger series, which is, like... I mean,
it's a different world.
It's a cool, like, it's not a bad series at all. It's strange a bit. But yeah. Oh. But No Man's Sky has the potential to be like the
I only have one. Nice.
What Nick, why me? You're just opening me up
Are
so that
Are you not
Austin...
getting the point? Wildcard.
Yeah. Well, you're just opening, like, you're opening me up to attack, leading to Austin being able to attack you and, like, murder you.
Then let him do that. I want to see what happens. I encourage it, Austin. Yeah. Do what you got to do, man. This is a game for all of us here. We're here to have fun. We're here to get a little dirty.
Wild card, bitches.
Wild card.
That's exactly right.
Well, I think I just lose next turn, so.
No, I can't kill you.
You still have the 5-5. I didn't get bold.
No, that doesn't matter. I lose.
You
I
have
die.
Two blockers. I can't kill you.
I have two blockers and you have four attackers.
Yeah, and you have lifelink.
Yeah. Oh, I'll still be down at like one health.
This game's hilarious.
It is kind of funny, actually, yeah. I'm starting to think my deck's actually real bad because the amount of times I've not gotten the combos I need are too numerous.
Do you have more than the 35 cards?
What?
Like the limit that they the limit that they set, like the minimum limit? Yeah, I lost.
I have a 60 card deck. What do you mean?
No, that's what I'm saying. Like in the when you're building your
the
deck,
split?
It says like of yeah, you have something out of 35 cards. Do you have more than that?
No, I played within all the rules that it gives.
Yeah.
I just probably have a split of a few too many various enchantments and instants where I need maybe a few more creatures and powerful stuff. Or I need to just distill the amount of combos down to a much smaller number.
God damn, do I really have to tap that many? Jesus Christ. Are you serious? Good
You're
lord.
Tapping the whole thing.
Tapping everything, man. Jesus.
Well, I lost.
Achievement unlocked. 5 creature discount.
Yeah.
What just happened? You just did 4
I
damage.
I lost. Yeah, I lost. Like, that's what I'm saying. Like, I was, like, playing against 2 fucking killed whole everything decks. I can't do anything. I lose.
Well, best thing you could do is block them.
I mean, I lose. There's nothing I can do. I've lost.
I didn't run
block them all.
Actually, I think I have 1 health. I have 1 health, I think.
All right, back up to 9.
No, it's going
to... No, back down to 1.
Oh, you have 1 health, yeah.
Yeah, but I fucking lost. I'm at, like, fucking nothing here.
Shit.
Well, that's not going to do anything for me. Well, I can't even go out doing anything cool. All right. Like, I just had cards to just defend against Austin, but, I mean, he's got 35 health and, like, 8 million flyers, so good luck, I guess.
I don't think you're gonna die. I think you're fine.
I'm dead. He can hit me with one of any flyers, and I'm dead.
But would he?
Yeah, absolutely. No reason not to. Like, I just had the flyers to defend myself against his, like, crazy ridiculous deck. I have nothing I could do.
Classic ridiculous deck.
It's weird I just played a bunch of cards this game. I didn't really get... The only combo I got was the creatures, and you stole most of them. I only have two left. Played a bunch of cards. Yeah.
I switcheroo'd like a 4/4 Angelic Edict.
You switcheroo'd three of my cards and Royal Elemental one. Still
yeah, Royal Elemental one. I took a Viscopa Guildmage with switcheroo. I took an Angelic Accord
and then a Bane
with switcheroo, and then the Baneslayer Angel. Yeah. But you still have two rune scarred demons.
Yeah, those are what are winning me the game, right? I've had those since turn two. I drew one. I had one and I drew one, and I haven't had enough land to play them until now.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Well, I lost. We both lost.
It doesn't really matter which I pick here. All right.
Yeah. GG.
What do you propose I do, Austin?
What?
Wild card, that's what.
Don't attack anyone.
You sure?
Yeah.
What about you?
You can attack Austin with your Scavenger Drake.
Why would I do that? He'll kill it.
You can't kill it.
He'll find a way. Love always finds a way.
He's only got one flying blocker right now. You could deal 10 damage right now or kill a Runescarred Demon, which is both very good for you.
Hmm.
But is that what a wild card would do, Rob?
I think a wild card would do, though?
That's a wild card play right now.
Is that
now.
A wild card play?
Oh, it's very Otherwise, you lose. Okay.
No, I'm kidding. Wild card. Gotcha.
I mean, I'm dead either way.
That was wild card. That was a nice fake out wild card.
That was a fake out wild card play. I cut the brakes, bitches! Wild card! Woo! Does he yee-haw at the end? I think
either
he does.
One, because he doesn't care. He's a wild card.
Yeah, well, you lost.
Oh, this looks good.
GG.
What's this about?
Yeah, goodbye. I told you, Nick. Oh. I tried to fucking tell you. I just had cards to, like, defend against him, but now I'm, like, dead and so are you.
Well, the things you tried to tell me about were not things that were out on the playing field at the moment.
Oh, I mean, you were killing my Baneslayer Angel and shit that was defending against him. Now we both lost.
That's okay.
You gave him the win.
I'm glad you switched root a bunch, Rob, because that gives me a bunch of blockers.
Yeah. Yeah, you have a bunch of land blockers.
Bunch of land blockers. Oh, no, I lost them all because you died.
Yeah, that's true. It doesn't matter, though.
I don't think he can kill me in one turn.
Yeah, he can't kill you in any amount of turns.
You draw a kill everything card, Nick.
No, it'd be sweet if I did, though, actually.
That would've been really cool.
You really should've used some of those kill cards on his fucking crazy shit.
I used them in various ways.
Yeah.
Is what I did.
You used them twice to kill my blockers to stop flying.
Those first two dead weights on the 1/1s were pretty
good. Well, that was hilarious, yeah. But the other two, like, the other two kill cards were used to stop my only defense against his attacks.
Should have said the dark arts.
Against the dark arts, yeah.
Against the dark arts, yeah. That's
dark arts.
Dark hearts.
Dark farts.
You don't even have to block that.
I'm going to, though. Because you never know.
If you don't go.
I know.
If you wanna go to the home out on the range, they got a lot of nice girls.
And how's the dong range? Uh-oh. Give all creatures death touch.
Okay.
But you still, doesn't matter.
What are you paragoning? Oh, you give thing one. Oh, you can give everything death touch. Oh no, you can give one thing death touch. You give it undying.
You still lost though.
No, I win now.
Oh,
you win.
Why?
That's cool.
Because he's just gonna hit you one time and you're dead.
Oh, that makes a lot of sense now that you put it that way. Exile target card from a graveyard. You gain life equal to it. All right, let's see what we've got. Chupa 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 chupa. You don't have anything good in your graveyard?
No.
If you have anything to get you above 20 health, then you can win. If you get to 21 health, you can survive a turn.
21's nope. Pretty good. I wish I had that much.
There's a base yeah. Air Angel in there, by the way, Nick.
Yeah.
Where? I didn't see it.
Austin wins with 32 health. My deck's not annoying.
It's really annoying, though.
I don't think it was there a second ago, or did I just go past it?
36 health. Just kidding.
There. I don't think I can get the 36.
That's unfortunate. Yeah. It's real annoying, Rob.
Yeah, your deck is real fucking annoying.
No, yours.
Mine is not annoying compared to yours. You really need to just switch decks.
It's really annoying. I didn't even, like, do any of the annoying combos this game.
You have three Angelic Accords on the field in this game.
I drew a lot of things this game. That's why
you got a lot of Angelic Accords.
I just drew a bunch
of. And I was fighting against getting fucking killed. My only blockers by fucking Nick as well. While I'm fighting you,
yeah, that's you're attacking. That's me. Actually a lot. Nick going at you was probably what didn't help at all.
I had literally 8 health at turn 5 because your stupid fucking lifelink death touch bullshit. Like, that's so dumb.
Commenters that say that the reason this is the way it is because Austin's the only one that has an actually good deck, and our decks are not very good, and we're just salty about it, so we try to take it out on him to make ourselves feel better.
Yeah, and that's why the commenters really, really hate the Inferno Titan and how Rob should stop bitching about how, because Inferno Titan's so OP. Yeah, okay.
Rob, the customer's always right.
Yeah, exactly.
First thing I learned in retail after 7 years.
Yeah. Oh, man.
Why is Final Fantasy VII trending on Twitter? Do people actually care that much, or are they just making fun of it that hard?
I don't understand.
Either way, we win.
So they're remastering it? They're not even putting it in HD or anything?
They're upscaling
the textures, they said.
Oh, okay. That takes, like, one click.
It still looks like it. Like all the characters are made of, like, 5 polygons. Are they going to change that?
How cool would it have been if they actually remastered it, though, and made it look
That'd
like
awesome. Final?
That would be absolutely amazing.
I would be hyped for that, because I'd probably play it, because I always heard 7 was the best, and I never played Final Fantasy, and
I would try it. When the PS3 comes out, they're going to remaster it. It's their biggest selling franchise. Of course they're going to remaster it. Come on.
It's like Nintendo's actually getting all the money by remastering Zelda series, and Sony's like, you know, let's just make the same. Let's not even do anything.
Speaking of Nintendo, they also said in that fucking Zelda thing, like, oh, when's Star Fox coming out? Oh, it's going to come out before Zelda next year. We've really worked on the touch and motion controls.
Yeah!
It's like, oh, please! He did, yeah, he did say that.
He said that. I think he just said it's coming out.
Exactly that. That's like, I'm paraphrasing, but he said, he even motioned with his hands with the gamepad for aiming. That's what the game is going to be. You're going to aim with the gamepad.
I want to take my hands, I want to place them palm down in the air, and then lock my thumbs together so it makes like an R-wing shape, and then I want to be able to fly in the game with my hands like that. Can the Wii make that happen for me, Rob?
There's got to be like a bunch of people there who are like, this is actually awful. Why are you doing this? There's got to be people there like who don't... Because it's not a comfortable position to play in. It's not intuitive. It's not... I just don't get it.
I don't get it either.
I kind of want to believe there's a bunch of, like, older Japanese men in business suits with party hats on spinning in place in chairs at the Nintendo home office. Like, just
I think that might be it, yeah.
Shooting party streamers in the air.
You know what it is? I think what's happening at Nintendo is the same thing that happened with George Lucas. Because, like, okay, to give you a little background here.
Yes, we get to do another Star Wars talk.
The reason that Crystal Skull, the Indiana Jones movie, was fucking god-awful was because half the ideas in that movie were actually a bunch of original ideas that were going to be in the original Indiana Jones 40 years earlier for Raiders of the Lost Ark. You can read the transcript and see, like, one of the ideas from Raiders of the Lost Ark that they took from the old ideas and moved it into the new movie was Indiana Jones swinging on fucking vines with a bunch of monkey friends and having monkey parties with monkey fights. That was from the original transcript of when they were doing the things, except Steven Spielberg and Lawrence Kasdan were in the room and they were like, George, that's fucking stupid, no. Like, we're not doing that.
Someone needs to make like a short movie of just George being told no, like he's some kind of pet or something. No, George, no.
No, stop it, George Lucas. Because that's
go
what
back in the fridge.
Before George Lucas was this big hotshot billionaire, you know, everybody could just be like, okay, George, no, that's a really fucking dumb idea. No, we're not going to do that. And then you have roll around the new trilogy, and no one in the room is going to, you know, George Lucas is a legend by the time the new trilogy of Star Wars comes out, and by the time Crystal Skull comes out, no one's going to say no to George Lucas. He's just going to do it. That's what's happening to Nintendo. Nobody's saying no to them. No one's like, no, that is fucking dumb. Stop it. But everybody, it's just an echo chamber of people like, oh yeah, and then we can motion control. I was gonna do a really bad.
You were definitely starting.
I'm really glad that
you pulled
I didn't
up at the last second.
Yeah, I did.
You made that it was, out of the nosedive there.
Yeah, that would have been far too racist for considering I'm berating them. But no one's there to be like, no, don't stop it, Nintendo. Stop it, Shigeru. Just don't anymore. Just please.
That's why I was really glad to see, like, yeah, they had the short motion control with the bow thing with the Zelda. It's like, all right, I can live with that. I still move around and swing the sword without...
You know there's more.
No. Even if the main mechanic, which is sword swinging, is not done with fucking motion control. So I'm okay.
It totally is. You know why? You want to know why I know it is?
Possibly.
I'll tell you why it is. When he said, what was that metallic sound that happened? It's like, oh, that means that you hit the enemy in the right spot.
Yeah. And how did you not have a right spot if not for motion controls?
I'm pretty sure he just said you hit him with an arrow, because I remember that.
No, you are misremembering this entire thing. He said you hit it in the right spot. That's it. That one is word for word what he said.
Also, don't forget there's going to be a sitar attachment to put the Wii tablet into because Link's going to play a sitar in this one. So you're going to actually have to hold the tablet sideways along the side of your body and pluck it with your fingers. It's the only way.
I don't see motion control work. Like actually, that wouldn't work with the tablet. Using the sword fight that wouldn't.
You think Nintendo cares whether
it works? No. I get that we're talking about how that's stupid. That just wouldn't work. That would you would be sitting there waving a fucking pad like an idiot.
I can't
like,
wait to throw it.
No. That actually wouldn't work. There's no way. There's actually no way.
They'll sell a tether, man. Tether it to either of your wrists.
But no, you can't swing it in enough directions to swing properly. Like
maybe
you wouldn't
you
even
can.
Be able to marry your moves properly.
Maybe you can. Yeah, they're just gestural now. You only have to suggest the direction you want to swing in, and Link takes care of the rest. And if you have trouble, Luigi will show up and give you help.
That's true.
I'm not on this train yet. I'm still high. I feel like there's still hope.
Oh, there's hope. There's definitely hope.
There's a new hope.
Yeah, but it's not looking
good. Wild card, bitches.
I think it is looking good though. That's what I'm saying.
I don't think it
but
is.
Zelda, I saw really nothing that I was unhappy about with that, and I heard nothing that I was unhappy with about. I mean, if you said the motion, we already knew that the star was going to have motion controls anyway. But like, I mean,
hey, all wild card aside, I haven't even seen the footage. I'm just enjoying this. That's all.
Hey, best case scenario, this is like 0.001% chance. It actually is. But there could be a best case scenario for Star Wars where they give you the option not to use the motion controls.
Star Fox? Yeah, no, that's not happening.
No. It's low. There's a low. It's very microscopic. But just because that is a chance that something that could happen possibly in the world, that chance is there.
Yeah, that chance exists. But it is so infinitesimally small.
It's very small, but you hold on to that, man. You hold on to that because you want another Star Fox. You want it.
You know, when Austin accidentally said Star Wars, it reminded me of the fact that the Wii remote is, like, exactly in the shape of a lightsaber hilt. And it just reminded me that they never actually made a proper Star Wars game with that.
Like, I don't understand
the whole
why.
Point.
Yeah, like, I...
I think they made the fucking Kinect thing, is what they did.
Well, I know they lost the licensing or something, but, like, it is... That technology exists for that one reason, basically, to make a proper Star Wars lightsaber battle game.
The Skyward Sword was not actually awful. It wasn't good, but it wasn't like it was bad. I mean, it worked, but it didn't work well. But if you're like playing a lightsaber game and the whole point is that, then that would work, probably.
The thing about the Link Sword thing is just a gimmick. It's like...
Oh, no, it is a gimmick, and I actually... banged the fucking shit out of my finger while I was playing Skyward Sword and the fingernail fell off. So,
wow.
Yeah.
You're just fucking yourself in the ass with your finger?
No, I was waving the sword around, and I was in school at the time, and I was in a very tiny room, so I was very close. I was just sitting down at a desk playing the game, and I was swinging the sword, because apparently Nintendo thinks that everyone has a giant bedroom with space.
It's a white living room with a beautiful white table and a white chair behind it, and a white sterile room around it.
Everyone has that. That's
and a beautiful family that can sit especially and watch when you're and in play college, with bated breath.
Yeah. But anyway, I was swinging. I kept well to stay away, but I just lost control at one point and smashed my finger into the desk.
They have a warning, you know, at the beginning that says to make sure you have full arm swing radius in all directions.
Dude, I could sit in the middle of the room and touch both the walls. That's how small the room was.
See, I think Nintendo would say you shouldn't be playing Wii in that room.
That was my room. There is no other
room. You
don't get
that. You can't use that room and use Wii.
Oh, okay.
They're incompatible.
I'll take it into the hallway then. And
that's the thing about the Wii, though, is that, like, I know people were smashing things and hurting their hands and doing all this other stuff with the Wiimote. When I first got the Wii, you know, I was doing the same thing where I was swinging wildly and stuff. But then after you play with it for a while, you realize that you absolutely do not have to do that at all. Yeah. You can do tiny little flicks
wrist
to do
gestures.
It. Yeah, exactly. And you accomplish the same goal, which at that point, you're... After you have realized how you've min-maxed playing Wii games with a Wiimote, you realize, what the fuck is the point of this?
Right.
Why don't you just give me a button?
You're one step away from min-maxing yourself back into a controller, which is where you should have been in the first fucking place.
Yeah. Exactly. Like, there's no reason. Like, if the complicated gestures aren't necessary because your motion controls suck, maybe don't put motion controls as your fucking premier thing.
But even if the motion controls work almost perfectly, it's still gonna be a subpar experience because
it is.
It's distracting. I've talked about this before, but when you're fucking waving around your hand like a goddamn idiot, you're pulled out of the game. You're pulled out of the immersion of the game, and it sucks.
You're also opening up yourself more to, like, injuries just based on repetitive motions. Like, moving your wrist in a certain direction a million times versus just moving your thumb. Like, your body is more in the ability to do that, I would say, than moving your whole wrist the whole time.
But that was the issue with Skyward Sword, is that even though it worked well enough to the point where I would say maybe it only messed up, like, 5% of the time, it's still, like, 5%'s... You can't have that. You can't even have, like, 1%, because if you, like, swing your sword and it doesn't work the way it should and you miss an attack, that should never happen. You should never have that happen in a game
The question is, would it happen if you had a button? Probably not.
No, it would never would. That's the thing, is a button is 100%. So the button would have to fucking break or something.
You just proved that it's worse, just there. You don't even need to go any further than that.
But even if it was 100%, like I said, it just wouldn't fucking be as good because you would be distracted. And it's just annoying.
At best, make
it's
it an option.
It's half-assed anyway.
Exactly. That's actually the huge make it an option.
It's half-assed anyway, too, because it's just like, okay, you have motion controls. Even if those specific ones, the Wiimote motion controls, were 100%. Like, the whole idea of motion controls is to make you feel immersed in the game, right? Which you've already gone over why it doesn't. Mm. And then secondarily, like, the motion controls, if you're holding a fucking wand in your hand that looks like a TV remote, like... There's no immersion gonna be happening there. That's not like using your hands when you move the remote closer to the fucking sensor bar. Like, that doesn't feel like you're using your hand. It feels like you're sitting and you're on your couch looking like an idiot, moving your hand around with these stupid plastic wands in your hand. Which is dumb.
It's not like they removed all the buttons and all of the other stuff that they were trying to simplify our world with. In fact, they've kind of made them less able to be reached. So then they have to kind of make all these weird workarounds, like if you're looking at the Paper Mario that came out for Wii, where they expect you to hold it sideways like an NES controller, and then they, like, applaud themselves for figuring that out. It's like, no, you just made a really unintuitive, uncomfortable controller with another purpose that cripples everyone's experience in every direction.
Yeah.
And the issue was that the game, Skyward Sword, was designed... It was designed by or around the motion controls, and so all the enemies were generic and just like, oh, slash in this direction, slash in that direction. Oh, almost every enemy in the game, every boss was like that. And so it made the items that you use almost even more pointless than they are in Zelda games already, to the point where you would never use them in combat because you're supposed to use the sword. And it's like they trivialized all the items in the game besides, like, the bow for some things. It's just really silly.
That one control concept literally cripples systematically through the entire game.
Yeah. Well, and they took away the whole thing too with that was really cool in Twilight Princess, right? Where you have like these cool combos and sweet shit that you can do.
Yeah,
like you can't have that anymore. Like Link looked like a fucking badass in that game, but in Skyward Sword he looks like an idiot, just like holding his sword at arm's length above his head because that's how you're holding the Wiimote as you're walking around. Like it's so dumb.
Yep. Twilight Princess is absolutely like the quintessential like Zelda for sword play. Like it was perfect. Like everything about the sword play in Twilight Princess was just really good and meshed well with the game that it was trying to be. And in Skyward Sword, like if Skyward Sword, I mean, there's plenty of other problems with Skyward Sword, but if the motion controls weren't there, it would have been so much better. It still would have been probably bad, but it still would have been so much better than it is. That's why I call it a really bad game, is because the motion controls drive it down even farther. But they like, if you just wouldn't have had that, it would have been probably enough to be like, all right, I still had a good time with this game. Instead, it was just like, I feel like I look like an idiot and this is awful. Never do this again. And I still think that from what I saw, they're going to take at least the focus of the motion controls out of the game.
I'm thinking of the ideal marketing scenario where one-to-one controller manipulation in motion tracking actually works the way that they imagine it. And think about, like, commercials that you've seen where, like, they get the kid in the Nerf bow and arrow scenario where he's, like, fucking everything serious and he's in an industrial complex and he's, like, shooting at this military organization. Like, that's what I think Nintendo thinks about when they're imagining people using the Wiimote. They imagine them, like, as Link with a sword, and that sword is right. The Wiimote, and they're fucking jumping around their living room, posing it behind their head and blocking reverse sword blows. And like, that's not what gaming is or looks like. It's a fucking fantasy. It doesn't make any damn sense, and it doesn't map to reality in any possible way. It's only good for marketing, and it's only good for short 15-second commercials. Beyond that, it makes no sense in reality.
I was just thinking, like, what if the whole Wii U is like a meta move by Nintendo, right? Like, maybe, hear me out, right? I'm gonna go into, like, an Illuminati conspiracy type of deal here, all right? Okay, so the Wii came out, right? The Wii came out, had motion controls. It came out too early. The motion controls weren't good. It was shitty. They had to come out with Wii Motion Plus later to make the only feature of their system work the way that it's supposed to work, and it barely does anyway. Okay, so the motion controls suck. Everybody hated the motion controls. Nintendo was critically panned for years over the motion controls, and Nintendo's like, okay, they're at headquarters, they're like, okay, motion controls not working out, everybody hates it, we should just go back to controllers next system. But then the business guy sitting in the back of the room, like the guy in Jaws who's about to tell the story about the shark and how it's going to cost him $20,000 to go eat the shark, that he shows up, he lights a pipe and he's like, we can't just go right back to we can't go back to controllers, because then we've just admitted failure. We've just said that we have failed on the motion controls. The Wii was a failed console. So then they decide, meta, okay, here's what we're going to do. We're going to wean them off motion controls. We're going to give them a gamepad and then other motion things. And then the next console, we already did the gamepad. It's not going to look like a failure. Next console, we're just going to have gamepads again. But we can't go right back. So here you go. That's the meta. That's the Illuminati conspiracy behind Nintendo. That's why the Wii U is a big piece of garbage.
I don't think that I can accept the premise that nobody thought motion controls were good just because they had, like, Wii Sports and Wii Bowling and that was a big deal. Yeah. It was a hit in the demographic they wanted it to be a hit with, but it was short-lived.
Yeah.
So it was successful. They want to try and bottle that again, and they want to keep trying to produce whatever narrative they feel like is appropriate for them at the time. So they're going to keep pushing a peripheral and saying, this is the new thing, and we're going to make you buy it, and then we'll abandon it, but you bought it, so we've got another direction to move in. Because what's the forward momentum with just, here's another controller? It's like, oh, well, how do we one-up that? Here's another controller. We can't make it better. It's got all the buttons. The best we can do is make a 360 controller. We did that already. What do we do from here? We make virtual reality? We tried that. Virtual Boy failed. What do we have left to do? They reach out in every possible direction until they run out of all directions. I think that's all it's about. Just reaching out.
I will say, originally, like, even in a video I made, was like, the Wii U gamepad is the dumbest thing ever. How could they just totally fuck up again? Since I've used it so far for, like, two or three games that I've played with the Wii U gamepad, I've actually enjoyed it. Like,
what's not to like about it? It feels fine.
Yeah, well,
it's fine.
Thought
It's flimsy, but it's fine.
The idea was that I didn't like the fact that you were going to be torn between two screens and it was going to ruin your immersion and all these things, but it just seems to work.
Tablet. I was talking about the Wii U Pro controller again.
No, I'm talking about the tablet.
We keep doing that. All right, go ahead.
But I thought it was going to break immersion way too easily and be really obnoxious, but for Mario Kart, it was really good. For Mario 3D Land, it was really good. 3D World. And I enjoyed it.
And here's why. It's optional. Almost every situation, you can just disregard it entirely. So that begs the question, why is it a thing that exists? You can play the system fine with the Wii U Pro controller. And they've made steps to not let you use it completely, but it's not enough that you can't still play it anyway. You just sometimes have to go get the tablet and look at it for 5 seconds and put it back away again.
The tablet, I think, has some good uses that they haven't really, I think they have actually used well. I mean, it's good to, if you have an inventory or you need to have a separate screen for extra things. And I think since they've made the tablet comfortable and they've made a good controller around it, that it does work, and that I do think it makes a point for itself to exist. But in Mario 3D World, there's a couple levels where you have to use the gamepad, to blow in the mic, and that's this is bad. This is everything else I like. You're doing good. This, don't do this.
Replicating the same scenario again with the Wii U controller where it's like, all right,
because I'm not waving the fucking thing around like an idiot.
The scenario we just described.
Just you wait, Star Fox Zelda, you're going to be waving it around like an idiot just in a second.
The thing is, at least the Wii remote was a fucking thing easy to wave around. This fucking tablet is not easy to wave around. It's very clumsy and huge.
You're going to have to hold up this big flimsy piece of shit plastic garbage toy, and you're going to hold it up to the screen, and that's how you're going to be playing Star Fox. You're not going to be looking at your nice big screen. You're going to be looking at the gamepad, because that's how you aim, and that's what you're going to look at. The Star Fox game on the Wii U is going to be on the gamepad. That's what you're going to play. You're not going to play on your big TV screen. You're going to be aiming through that thing. So why the fuck would you look at your big TV screen?
It's a disgusting, gluttonous celebration of excess is what that is. Holding up a device in front of another device for no fucking reason? Come on.
Yeah. That's what we can expect. Same with the goddamn arrow.
You know what would be the worst thing? Is that underneath this shitty motion control Star Fox game is a really good Star Fox game.
That's exactly what it will probably end up being.
It's going to be an amazing Star Fox game that is destroyed by the worst motion control idea ever.
No, you know what? Considering how they've treated the series since Star Fox 64, I doubt it'll be.
It might be awful too.
The poetic
irony. I would be okay at that point. I'd be like, all right, you ruined something that was already bad. We were never going to have anything good anyway.
Because I know what they're going to do. They're going to do the same thing that they did with Star Fox Assault. And I'm not even flaming Adventures, because Adventures is a whole other category of flame that I'm not even going to go into. But the Star Fox Assault, which was supposed to be for purest Star Fox fans on the GameCube, that one, you spend half the game running around with these awful, awful ground controls as like a third person shooter for no reason. I don't give a shit that there's a fox in the ship. I just wanted to see the ship, and I want to shoot things in outer space on a rail because that's Star Fox. Don't make me run around in this environment, running around, because the aiming is fucking awful. It's the thing where it tracks back to the center, or if it doesn't track back to the center, then you're just aiming in a direction like Doom, and you're trying to tilt the way you're aiming, and it's just why would you even fucking do that? It was so infuriating. And then Assault also, that's the other thing about it, is it's completely fucking linear. Completely linear. There's just a straight linear story, and it's all about the story and the love affair with Crystal, the blue fox lady, and Fox, the fox guy. And I don't care. I don't give a shit. Just let me shoot things in space. Let me shoot dudes in space. That's all I want. I just want to have cool space dog fights with a fox instead of a dog. I want to have a fox fight in space. That's all I want.
There's a dog sometimes. He just only drives the big ship.
Well, yeah, he's General Pepper. He's there for the whole.
He's a cool guy.
I know that's what's gonna happen with the Star Fox. I know.
I'm surprised if it's coming out so soon that we haven't seen anything with it yet. That surprises me, because if it's coming out before Zelda and we've seen Zelda now, we should probably see Star Fox soon.
It's going to be actually Star Fox's epic yarn. It's going to be Star Fox's yarn universe instead.
Star Fox's epic yarn. If there's anything that describes Nintendo, that's it.
You don't think this is just another marketing thing where they're going, well, we have almost absolutely nothing done of this, but we need to show it off to keep hype up, and then we'll just release something?
Because like I was saying,
it's just not gonna work.
They have nothing on the horizon. Like, the things that they have on the horizon are Zelda, which they're saying is like next year, which by what they have shown so far, like in the original E3 months ago, we dissected the image. There was nothing there. They didn't build any of the world. It was a 2D image on a little tiny bit of 3D world. And then they showed this here, and they didn't show it up front. They showed it off a TV screen at the corner of the image, and there's almost nothing in the world. There's just some trees. Like, it looks like a fucking, like you're walking around in a Proteus level. Like, there's nothing there in the game yet. There's no story, there's no characters. You can move around on a horse, but there's nothing there. They have nothing to show. And the same with Star Fox. Oh yeah, it's coming out next year, but they just have to build hype because they have nothing on the horizon.
But we're talking about a difference of 6 months. You don't go from a static image to a full living, breathing world in 6 months.
No, I know, but I mean, they're making it seem like they have more than they do, and they don't.
Right.
That's the thing. And that's what's really fucking scary to me, because I don't want them to rush that game. I really want this next Zelda to be good. I really do, because if it doesn't sell well, and if it does poorly, then what's stopping it from being Metroid, where they're just gonna be like, nah, or Star Fox, or fucking, you know, F-Zero. They're just gonna be like, all right, we won't have a Zelda on the next console cycle. We'll leave it to 15 years from now. Like, I don't want that. I want a good Zelda so that we can be excited about it, and for it to be good, and I enjoy it because Zelda is my childhood and I love it, and I love that series, and I want it to be fucking good, and I don't want it to die.
I'm thinking about the EA comparison here of, like, so they go ahead and release this thing, and it turns out to be really shitty because they didn't have enough time to develop it. Then it gets really bad reviews. Then it doesn't sell very well. And then they decide, we actually don't like Zelda, so they're just not going to make another one for a long time.
Well, hold on now. Nintendo doesn't have a history of releasing unfinished games.
In the specific that we're talking about. No,
he's joking. He's being ironic, right? You're joking.
Wind Waker is a perfect example of in this exact same series of a game, the Zelda game that was rushed to completion.
Were you not joking?
I know Wind Waker, but is there anything else?
Yeah, there's a lot of games where they completely rushed the development of. Like, there was also, fucking Majora's Mask was made in a year. That didn't feel unfinished, but that was made in a year. I mean,
that's already from Ocarina.
Yeah,
but I'm not comparing games that are like unfinished and there's missing things in the game. I'm talking about like Assassin's Creed. The game is just broken and isn't finished.
I don't think Nintendo makes things that are just broken, but I do think they make things that are unfinished and they rush release dates. And if they're fucking saying that this game's gonna come out next year, They got to be working their ass off on this game, and I honestly don't even know if there's enough time.
We're still inferring that just because they didn't show anything that there's nothing there. I mean, this is the same argument I made with the E3 thing. I mean, they could just not want to show things yet. They don't want to reveal. You know, they could just. It was the Game Awards. It wasn't anything huge. They just wanted to show, you know, the game as in its base form.
Then why didn't they show it on the screen? Why did they show it as
fucking Nintendo's really weird, man.
I don't know. I feel like you're stretching what we have seen to match what we want. And I totally
I'm not stretching
want
it. I'm not saying it's like going. I'm saying that I don't think we can say that it's going to be unfinished or that's likely just because we haven't seen anything yet.
Well, I don't know. We'll see. If the game launches and it has...
I feel like we're still really, really in the dark on almost most of the game, or nearly all of the games, so I don't think we can say that there's nothing there.
You're completely right. We don't know any of this information. That's just speculating. But we're speculating with the hope that we have a little bit of education based on what we know about the way the industry works. Still, you're right. We don't know.
But they've been working on this game for 4 years now.
Wait, why do we know that?
I don't know.
They always start a new Zelda after their old Zelda. That's how they develop Zeldas.
I don't know that we know that.
Yeah, like,
come on. You're not telling me that even like 6 months after Skyward Sword came out that they...
If they were working on it for 4 years, do you think they really would have shown a 3D, like a small 3D world against the 2D backdrop for their E3
conference? Nintendo, man.
I don't know what that means, though, because, like, I don't think what they have showed at E3 and even at the Game Awards is not 4 years of work. That is nowhere near 4 years of work. But that's again,
that's on the assumption that they wanted to show us more, or they didn't want us.
The thing is that Zelda is such a full, robust game full of areas that have absolutely no cinematic quality that even the areas that have nothing going on in them should have looked better.
Yeah.
Did you play Twilight Princess?
Yeah. Why?
There's nothing in Twilight Princess in the overworld. There's actually nothing.
Oh yeah, and that sucks. That like
that's one of the negatives.
Oh, so
about
we're aspiring for it to be.
No,
mediocre,
I'm just saying
then.
That. Well, we're not taking into account how big the world was that they showed too. So there could be gaps of, you know, actually nothing, and it would be okay.
But the idea is when you're hyping something, you show the best thing you can show without spoilers. And there's plenty of areas in any Zelda game where you could show
you know
that.
How Nintendo is with spoilers.
They showed a tower, they showed some trees, and they showed a horse. And then they showed a bunch of enemies getting shot in a field. Two of them, in which Link does the exact same motion two times in a row where he flips off the horse in slow-mo. Like, they didn't show anything at all. Like, there's nothing. Like, those are just, like, console added into that area in the field there. There's, like, nothing there. There's nothing in the game yet.
You can't say that, though. You can't say that in the game yet.
He's
saying it with a star at the end, saying, but we really don't know.
Yeah, we really don't know, sure. But, like, from what they showed... I mean, I remember when they first did that that conference before when we initially saw the Zelda thing and you said yeah that well no they wouldn't show it like a 2D image against the thing, and then we looked at it and it totally was a 2D image, like a skybox against just a really small 3D environment. Like that was also a thing. There was nothing in the game at that point, like nothing at all in that scenario. In 6 months later, there's at least some world to walk around in, but there's nothing in the world yet, I don't think. Anyway, again, like asterisk of course, but like it turns out with what they've shown now, I was totally right back then. So I don't know, man.
I love that we've banded together to become this group of pioneers to try and figure out the intentions of this big company to try to determine the trajectory of a franchise that we love but has had dips. Like,
yeah.
We need to find out because we need to become soothsayers that can read the future of this information based on the little tidbits we've been given. Because it's fucking Illuminati shit.
Right.
I just want to know. I want to be able to be to know before. Because what I need is
validation.
I need to. No. I need to not have hope. Because I want to be. I don't want to be disappointed.
You know what? That's right. That's what this is about. This is about us being able to give up our hope sooner rather than being strung along by corporate bullshit longer.
Because I would totally be so much happier with being pleasantly surprised by the game being amazing than I would in being horribly disappointed that they fucked up my favorite childhood franchise of all time. Like, I would be so much happier to be pleasantly surprised that the game is way better than I expected and I was flaming it for no reason. Like, I would love if I was right, if that's how it was. I would love to be wrong. And I need to stay cynical, because if I don't and I get hyped about Zelda and it's awful, which... honestly, is a fairly decent percentage chance. I think we got like a 50-50 shot of this being a really terrible game or a good Zelda game. And there's like a 10% chance that it's like, or like a 5 to 10% chance that it's like the greatest Zelda game in the series. But like, I need to not set myself up for that, because I don't think I can handle it.
Dude,
I don't think I can handle it.
If they had a Kickstarter campaign and I could somehow give them $60 just to know, like, with no corporate bullshit, like, is this going to be terrible? Just, like, level with me? I would pay it.
Yeah,
just to have the year of relief or whatever it takes.
See, I don't think they have any reason to rush a terrible game, though. Like, they're on the... Nintendo is... This past 6 months have been doing very well.
Yeah, it's good, but what about their next holiday release?
You do business based on the future. You don't do it based on the current.
Right.
What's their holiday release cycle after this? This was certainly the best year for the Wii U and Nintendo properties for the past, like, 5 years.
And it had to
be. Absolutely. Yeah, but yeah, and it definitely had to be. But then what do they have on the horizon? They don't have anything. There's nothing coming out. There's no new Pokemon. There's no new... I mean, there's the Donkey Kong made of fucking yarn, but who gives a shit about that? And then...
Wait, Donkey Kong's made of yarn now, too?
Yeah, they have a yarn Donkey Kong now.
No,
I thought it was Yoshi or something.
Yoshi, yeah.
Oh, it's Yoshi.
It's not Donkey Kong, you silly Donkey Kong.
I'm sorry. I was thinking about the next one that they're going to do. They're going to make the Donkey Kong made of yarn.
A yarn Pikachu game would be
next. They have the Yoshi game, which is like, who the fuck is going to actually buy that first? Like,
I thought
first
it was a
all,
sequel to Yoshi's Island. I thought a lot of people would buy that.
Yeah, how many people still are, like, alive or care about Yoshi's Island since Yoshi's Island 2?
Wait,
like,
what?
When Yoshi's Island...
that are alive? That's our whole generation.
Yeah, no, but, like, how many people who have that are, like, really, really pumped for Yoshi's Island 2, though? Because that's the thing.
The people
is that,
who are
like,
going to yell at us in the comments are those people.
When Super Mario World 2 Yoshi's Island came out, people were like, oh my god, this is really cool. This is like a totally new, like, platformy type thing. I really like this. Nintendo, make another one. And Nintendo's like, okay, yeah, sure, we'll make another one. Just, you know, 20 fucking years later. And, like, you know, it's just, I don't know if anybody's going to buy that game, to be honest with you. I don't think that game's going to do very well. And then you have the Toad game that's coming out.
That
might
be out already. I feel like I've seen someone stream it.
I think it comes out very soon.
Maybe it's
out
in Japan already.
I know the reviews all came out, and apparently it's getting really good reviews.
I'm sure it's good. I'm sure the Yoshi game's going to be good, too. But I don't think anybody's going to buy them.
I don't know, man.
That's the thing. Like,
blind Nintendo allegiance is still strong in some areas.
That's the weird thing, though. Is that, yeah, Nintendo doesn't have anything on the horizon, but all the games for, like, Xbox and PS4 on the horizon are generic first-person shooters and horror games.
Yeah, but I don't care about those games.
I'm not counting
any games. Anyway. And they're not going to sell anything, or those are all going to sell anyway. Like all the first person shooters, because everybody's like going to, you know, whine to their mom like, oh, I want to kill people in like glorious HD and drink their taste the blood on their on my lips.
I know Unity didn't work at all, but it's in Victorian London this time, Mom. I'm freaking out here.
Yeah, so those are going to sell. Like there's no worries about that. And then, like, the other, because, like, the thing you have with, like, Wii Sports and stuff, or, like, a lot of Wii shovelware, is that, you know, your mom, like, the demographic is little tiny kids, right? And your mom is not going to know who the fuck Toad is. She's not going to know who the fuck, whatever the other game we were talking about was. Like, she's not going to know that. What she's going to see is she's going to see a $60 game, and then she's going to see, like, Ivan Gecko's platformer adventure for $10, and she's gonna go get that one because the kid's not gonna be like, "Yeah, I want the Toad game because I love Toad so much, Ma."
There's so few third-party games on Wii U. There's no other options, man.
I'm sure there actually are. There's a lot of shovelware on Wii U. I've never seen it, but I'm sure it exists because the Wii was filled with shovelware.
Third parties all abandoned Wii.
Even, like, the shovelware?
There's not a lot of people developing for Wii U.
There's not a lot of Wii U games. Not at all.
Yeah.
The section is usually like a quarter the size of the Xbone and PS4 section, which is saying something because both of those don't have a lot of games either.
Yeah. Eesh.
Can we? Oh, we're talking about FPS. Can we talk about, like, did you see The Order, Nick?
Yeah, but I still don't understand it necessarily exactly what it is. But they're really trying to sell me a lot of shit about it.
It was. I don't know. I didn't know either until I started to see the gameplay. Like, they showed some FPS gameplay. Yeah.
Apparently, they're trying to sell me, like, blunderbusses and shit with three barrels, and I'm like, I don't even know what this game is. Can you calm down with the season pass?
They straight up, like, there was a dude, they were in this place, and they were cover shooting, and the guy was taking, he had regenerating health, and there was the classic red jelly, and you just go on shooting dudes, and the gun shot, it straight up looked like the most
red jelly.
Generic. Yeah, dude, you know classic red jelly.
I know green jelly, because I played The Evil Within. You collect the green jelly and you submit the brains to the electric chair and you power up your Resident Evil character.
Yeah. But you do know what I mean by red jelly, right?
No.
The stuff that splashes on your screen when you take damage.
Oh.
It's red jelly.
Yeah, or scuff marks or fucking any dirt.
Yeah, but
depends what game it is.
The red jelly term was coined for Modern Warfare 2.
Oh, okay.
And that was cool.
I never understood that either when they do that in like Battlefield or like in
they took it from light gun
in like
games.
Far Cry.
It's the
no, yeah,
thing
like
ever.
No, I know, but like because like the whole idea with that, right? Or at least like when they like, oh, there's a boot mark on the front of the screen, or like, oh, they cracked the whatever. And there's dirt on
eyes.
There. It's like, yeah, no, because that's the thing. That's like, okay, yeah, it's supposed to be immersive, but, like, hold on a second. When do I get a fucking splatter of dirt in my eyeballs? Like, that doesn't happen. And if it does, it doesn't just, like, slowly fade away. That just looks fucking stupid. But I don't know, man.
Yeah, no, it's just the order looked so actual. It almost looked like a parody. It was so generic. Even the chat, the Twitch chat, was just, like, you know, the classic.
I agree.
Yes.
It's super generic looking, and is the big hook that it's like some kind of Victorian London steampunk thing?
I guess, yeah.
Because the dude had a mustache, which is why I figure that. And also, he was wearing kind of old.
There was like blimps too, you know, classic steampunk blimps. And
so that's all we have these days. It's like the fucking manatee balls from South Park. You take all these concepts on one side. Was it manatees or was it like seals or something?
It was manatees, yeah.
Right, and so we've got steampunk, we've got Victorian London, we've got third-person shooter cover, jelly, whatever, and then they just move those balls together, and then we get that game. That's how we determine what comes out now.
Basically, yeah.
So they happen to draw twice with Assassin's Creed and The Order on the same group. They must have very few balls in the tank. They should really add a few more.
Yeah, yeah, and what was it, the Dead Man, or was it the last game that they showed, the other shooter with the angsty teen, what was it called? I keep forgetting what it's called.
Angsty teen shooter.
Yeah, the one with the paper, the writing, the drawings or whatever.
Oh, Drawn to Death.
Drawn to Death, there it is. I couldn't remember. That's the same thing. They drew the angsty teen card, which is a rare one. Angsty teen drawing card.
Well, you know, I am assuming it's the same developer and publisher that made Drawn to Life, and they've just reversed the image there. Because that was a DS game that was also not very popular. But it looked of equal production quality.
The guy who was presenting that game was really weird. He just started, like, cussing. He was like, yeah, they said I could cuss, so whatever. It's like, okay.
Wow, that's so edgy. That's equally as edgy as the game, which has gratuitous blood for
it.
It
was really edgy. And it was angsty, too. Edgy for me.
It's a lot of edginess. Those interviews, I must say, when I was watching that PlayStation Experience, I watched the one with No Man's Sky, and the dude doing the interview was just saying the most random bullshit to the dude trying to present his game. He, like, started asking him, he's like, so can we have, like, a tea party on a planet? What if I find a planet with a tea party on it? Can we do that? He's like, that is the most specific request. Like, he didn't even know what to say. And later on, he said something else equally random, and he completely lost his train of thought when he was trying to actually complete a statement.
Can I give the creatures on the planets tattoos? Can we do that?
You know what that is? That's like, oh hey, we're marketing this as the first ever Game Awards, so that like regular mainstream people who don't like video games are gonna watch it. We're gonna get this halfway celebrity interviewer here who, like, you know, maybe some people know if they watch like.
I'm talking about PlayStation Experience, though.
No, I know. I know. The same kind of thing where it's like they probably get some guy who knows nothing about video games, has no experience in the field. He's just like, this is the guy that you get for this because he's the next one up. And then he has no idea what to fucking do, probably. That's what I would guess.
I got the impression he was very nervous and he was trying to come across overly personable, but he was doing it in a really creepy way that was also confusing.
Creepy and confusing.
We haven't talked about No Man's Sky. They showed more of that.
I didn't see any of the new stuff. Is it good? Does it look cool?
It's so weird because we've gotten to the point.
Stuff, there's not new stuff. Really.
Yeah, it's gotten to the point where we were like, all right, this concept is really cool. It's actually one of the coolest concepts I've seen, and it seems to work, but this game actually still needs to be a game. We need to see some of that now. Because
doesn't need to be a game, but they need to start telling people if it is or it isn't.
Right, because at this point I'm like, all right, I still think this is one of the coolest, and it looks believable. Like, at first I was like, there's no way this is going to work. Like, right, that's what everyone's saying when we saw it. Like, this has got to be overblown. But it seems to work, but there's no gameplay. There's actually none besides flying around.
I'm imagining just a third or 3D version of Starbound, essentially, where we get some random generation, but there's like 20 assets. And then after you've gone through three planets, you've seen everything the game has to offer.
Right. And there's really nothing much to do.
That's the question, yeah. That's like...
But it sucks because it's like, No Man's Sky seems like they've had a really good engine. The engine seems really good and it seems to work. The only negative seems to be the draw distance, but that's understandable seeing as how...
Yeah, it is super short.
Yeah, but
there's
I'm okay
combat,
with it.
Combat, you know.
Well, I haven't seen it.
the spaceship has combat. I'm not sure if there's combat on the ground. Right. The idea is that people can steal your ship or kill your ship and then leave you stranded on a planet until someone else picks you up, which in an endless procedurally generated universe, that likely would never happen.
Yeah.
So I'm not really sure what you do about that, but there's supposed to be resources that you can gather. You can become a trader, I've been told, or you can be a more combat-focused character. I'm not sure what that means in terms of gameplay, other than maybe you'll look for things or you'll fight people. Maybe you want to steal stuff.
If they can make it more Eve-like without all the crazy shenanigans that's in Eve that makes it scary to start, that would be cool.
Well, they're going to do the... If that's how they're marketing it, then they're going to make it the traditional, like, freelancer type model of fly around as a pilot thing, where you're going to be mining resources off of worlds. Or you're going to be a pirate and attacking star bases and stuff, except it's procedurally generated. Which, honestly, to tell you the truth, if that's what they're saying, then I know what type of game it's going to be, and I'm a little bit disappointed. Yeah, I'm like slightly disappointed about that. But if it's a good version of that, then that's actually pretty good, because there really hasn't been too many that have been particularly good in that regard. I mean, there was X3 recently that I think people really liked, but I never really got into.
Well, if that's what they're going for, it doesn't sound like enough to me, because that doesn't seem to play off the engine very well.
Yeah,
I mean,
no, that
you have
doesn't
all
address
these...
any of it. All they talk about is exploration, which leads me to believe it's like Proteus on multiple planets, which I could be okay with if that's what we're marketing it as, but they haven't made that clear.
Yeah, that's what I would like too. I would totally appreciate if it was like a, you know, explore and see the weird procedurally generated worlds that are like, you know, totally different. Like, you get the feeling that you're totally flying around and stuff. I mean, and the ability to go from orbit right into the planet, like, that's cool. But
I feel like that would get old real quick.
Nah, I don't know if that'll get old. If you're, like, I don't know, that's pretty fucking cool, man. Like, I'd be really excited about that. Especially if they're, like...
ability to be jaded.
Yeah, but I mean, like, if you see, like civilizations on there, like, that'd be really cool. Like, I'd be really pumped about that, honestly. Like, I still think Starbound's, like, where you move to a new world animation is, like, really fucking cool. Like, I never got tired of doing that. In fact, I was really disappointed that, like, they made it so difficult to move from world to world, in at least in the initial beta that I was playing, or the alpha, rather, that, like, they were, like, really nerfing it so you could only go around to a new world every once in a while, at least in the early game, and it's just like, oh man, that's like the whole point of the game. That's I want to explore. I want to be able to be free to explore, not have to spend 3 hours grinding to get to the next world or something, you know?
Starbound to me still is the most disappointing game I've ever played.
It's still not done.
That's why, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, it should. It's at this point it's at now, it still shouldn't be released. It's still that unfinished.
Yeah.
And this is why I was angrily yelling earlier today about how every possible permutation of thing that seems to exist is all about how can we market games that aren't finished and call them various names.
Yeah.
It's just made everything so difficult. I just want a finished experience sometimes, and we just can't seem to find the middle ground. Because if it's not done, we're waiting for it to be in pre-release, in alpha, in beta, in early access, in green light, in every other fan-funding name you can come up with. Then once it's done, we're immediately moving on to all the expansion packs and DLC and the season pass. It's like, can we just have one finished slice of an experience from beginning to end that we can judge on its own merits? That's all I want.
It's so weird, too, because there's been so many games recently where it's like, we released and the game's not done, but it's going to be done soon. And then I totally missed that it actually released, like, because they released the unfinished thing, and I think a good example is State of Decay on the PC, where they released it on the early access, but they were like, yeah, but we released this, but you shouldn't play it because it doesn't work. And I was like, okay, I won't play it for a while, and that's fine. And then, you know, like, 3 months later, and I hear, oh, first DLC for State of Decay now live on Steam. It's like, whoa, hold on a second, DLC? You have an expansion to the game that's not done? Or is it done? Is it released? And then you go back, and it's like, yeah, it kind of released, but also not really. And it's like, what the... Like, what? I don't understand. That is the way to kill the hype around your game.
Especially when we've now reinforced that when games release that they're fucking broken. Like,
yeah.
So now the general sentiment is, so when a game's done, we have to wait 3 months before we can play it for the finished version. And then by that time, we've already moved on to expansion packs 1 through 5. And if you're not into the hype for that, which you probably wouldn't be because you're pissed that the game was broken when it launched, you completely miss the entire release cycle for that game. And then what? You wait for it to go to Game of the Year edition, get all the DLC for $19.99, and none of that whole release extravaganza played up to you, and it was all wasted marketing. Now, if the entire industry moved into that thought process, we would have a very different industry. And I think that's what needs to happen at this point. And this is coming from somebody who plays alpha and beta games for a living. Like, that's what I do. I don't begrudge them because they don't market them as being finished.
Yeah. Yeah. And they don't charge, like, $60
right.
for them.
And almost like, every game I play is free.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, like, that's the other thing, too, is that, like, the state of the industry is very unhealthy.
It's always been kind of for about, like, 6 or 7 years now. But these past 2 years have been really bad. And especially this year. This year, it just keeps getting worse.
Yeah, it's been bad.
Well, it's got to get bad enough that we can all unify and decide to, like, start sending a message, we'd like something new, please, instead of just keep buying into it.
It might just pop, honestly. It already popped once. It could happen again. Like,
people always say that. I don't know what that means when it pops.
Well, there was the games crash in the 80s.
Yeah, I know, but what does that mean now? Games. We don't have the same
culture.
That
was such a different time, though, with such different, like, variables.
Yeah, we can't have a crash to the same extent because there's a million different threads all running that all have their own version of micro-industries within this industry. So not the whole thing is not going to go down at once.
Well, no, I don't think like there's going to be the black day of video games.
Right, and that's
like,
what happened in the 80s.
Silent. Well, sort of. It didn't exactly happen that way, but yeah, I mean, like, it could still, bad things could happen. I mean, like I was saying, with the way the industry is right now, it's a little bit unhealthy in that, like, successful games have to spend, you know, $110 million, or at least the AAA releases have to spend $110 million, and then companies have to shit on their consumers and then also charge $60, and the game isn't finished, and then everybody enjoys it and hates it at the same time, but buys it, and it's...
The 60 is just the ticket that gets you in the door so you can buy the other $70 worth of stuff later.
Well, and that's the thing, too, is that they have to keep spending more and more to make these games, and then when you spend more and more money, that means you sacrifice more and more artistic integrity. Not to say that, like, a game that's cost all that money is not a piece of art, potentially. I mean, it totally potentially is, but I'm just saying that, like, you know, after a point, we already see it in the games industry where games kind of have to sacrifice mechanics or sacrifice cool ideas and then replace it with regenerating health bars or open world or whatever, you know, stuff that just is trendy at the time. And, you know, there are, like, little glimmers of hope that exist, like potentially No Man's Sky, or you have, like, Shadow of Mordor and, what was the other one, Sunset Overdrive.
Shadow of Mordor. Very good.
Yeah, no, that's what I'm saying. It's a glimmer
of
hope.
I was saying that to Nick, but I was going to say that, like, yeah, Shadow of Mordor was such a weird surprise.
Yeah, like, exactly, yeah.
Well, no, but it's fine, but, like, it's not like it's not more than derivative. It's a kind of a generic hack-and-slash game that happened to get a lot of things right. It didn't really take any risks.
Whoa, are you crazy? The captain system is, like, the nemesis system is completely...
Oh, come on, that's still generic as hell. It's just some weird attributes.
I mean, well, it's not the attributes. It's that anything in the world could potentially become your enemy, and then you can upgrade them and do... There's like a strategy element that they added a layer on top that no game had ever really done that specific system before.
It being a hack and slash? It's still the same thing with just a layer on top of it. It seems like a marketing thing more than anything.
It doesn't need to change the way that it's a hack and slash. I don't think. I mean, like, how could you even change a hack and slash? Like, just make it with motion controls? Like, I don't know what else you would do. I think that's an example of something like, hey, they took a risk on a weird idea that people potentially could totally like. I could 100% see some businessman sitting in a room when they pitch the Nemesis system and they'd be like, oh, consumers, they're not going to understand that. They're not going to understand how orcs are going to level up and go to different things. They're not going to understand how that system works. You got to take it out of the game. That, like, I could see that happening, and I'm sure that conversation happened several times over the course of development with Shadow of Mordor. But, I mean, they did something that was totally different from a lot of things. Yeah, the rest of the game was totally derivative. I mean, even the combat system was, like, pretty much... you know, line of code for code from Batman, but, you know, the rest of it is really cool. I mean, the story was boring, but the Nemesis system is a really cool idea, and that's a little bit of a glimmer of hope. I mean, it's a huge risk, actually, in AAA. In AAA, that's a huge risk. In an indie game, that wouldn't be a huge risk. That would just be, like, an indie game, but in AAA, that's fucking massive.
I think like, the context of why it's massive is because they could have gotten away with not doing it, and that could have also been fine.
They would have totally. I mean, if they didn't do that, though, that game would be totally mediocre. The fact that Nemesis system is in the game, it makes the game super-duper fun, and I put, like, 50-plus hours into it. So, like, you know, that's the difference between, like, an alright game and a pretty darn good game. Like, I could say that's one of the best releases of the year. Absolutely.
Yeah. I mean, it was nominated for Game of the Year in the award show. The one we don't give any credit to.
Yeah.
Dark Souls 2 was nominated for Game of the Year, and I was like, are you fucking kidding me?
Here we go.
And here we go. People got mad at me for saying that on Twitter, by the way.
I don't dislike Dark Souls 2 as much as you guys do, but...
This came up on the NLSS, too, and I was like, let's just not.
Okay, when Nick says, like, let's just not about talking about Dark Souls 2 and how it's bad, we've really beaten that horse to actual pulp.
Well, someone asked about what do I feel about the remake, and I also didn't I didn't know enough about it at the time to realize that they apparently were re-releasing the game with a new engine.
Is that even true? No, it's just the game with DLC.
It's the game with DLC is what I said to that person, and then they were like, no, that's not true, it's a new engine. Like, you sure you didn't read into that release too much? Because I didn't hear that.
It's the thing that we were talking about a couple episodes ago, where they did it's got the new HD graphics or whatever.
They said
and all
they were
going
to add better textures to it, which honestly would be great if they actually do that. But I have a feeling it's just going to be the same textures with like higher level of bump mapping or some bullshit on it.
People were so hyped about it. I was like, guys, this is exactly what we don't want. Like in the games industry,
this is rewarding them for the same shit again. This is just mediocrity multiplied.
Like, all the things that make the game not good are still going to be in the game.
Hey, we don't know that 100%. I'm certainly going to find out when it comes out if it is, but I won't be surprised in the least when it's exactly the same.
When all the enemy placements are awful and generic and all the designs of the enemies except for, like...
fucking wall and the fucking wall doesn't explode the wall either and all the... Yeah. At the very least, you can't say I didn't play the shit out of that game, because I did, and I know enough about it to have a serious amount of critique
to it. I played through it. It's weird. Like, people are like, well, why do you keep playing? Why'd you play it, like, 3 times if you don't like it so much? It's like, well, I mean, it's still Dark Souls, and Dark Souls is still one of the best combat systems ever in gaming, and it still has, you know, great atmosphere. I mean...
It's the argument that we're having with Nintendo all over again, that they're taking an IP we love hostage and putting it through a bunch of shit we think is awful.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
The core game is fine. Just please make it better.
There's so much to do with Dark Souls, and instead he just makes like 7 castles with the same textures. And there's a forest, I guess, and that's it. And there's this cool underground cave that is actually, you can't see anything.
Did you
see
the DLC
bridges.
In the snow area? Did you see? Did you see the screenshots?
I did.
It's like one awful jagged texture across the entire plane of vision.
Yeah, it's bad.
I like pulled my hair when I saw it. I'm like, what are you doing? This is so easy. Just fucking shift the texture a little bit so it doesn't tile as much.
I don't know. We've talked about this. Me and Nick, we've gone over it probably like 1,000 fucking times now. I just don't get why people think Dark Souls 2 is good.
I just want to throttle the people that fucking put the textures on the walls because I know how to do it better than they do. I don't work in this industry like that.
Oh. We've
it's care and attention. It's a very small level of detail that you need to pay respect to your work that will show through so easily. And when you had the excuse that the lighting wasn't going to be there and the engine changed at the last minute so you shouldn't have been able to see these textures tiling, that's one thing. But when you make the DLC, we already knew what the constraints were, right? You don't have that excuse anymore.
I saw the final boss of the DLC too, and it's like really bad.
The thing that instant kills you or what? The thing you have to not be invisible for or whatever?
No, it's just like it throws like 20 enemies at you at once and is like, have fun. It's like, oh, you mean that thing that made the rest of the game real bad? You know, fighting 5 enemies at once in a game that favors 1v1 combat? Okay. I guess we're going to keep doing that. It's like they forgot how to make the 1v1 combat hard, so let's just put 500 enemies everywhere.
I was going to say, yeah. Rob doesn't even have to be here to read the comments for this one, but he does. He does. We should have done this one on Friday. We could have flamed everybody, and Rob wouldn't have had to see it for like a week.
Also, we're at an hour and 40 minutes.
I want to be mad at Dark Souls 2 again. I haven't done that in a while.
We can do that in the next episode.
Okay, we'll do that in the next episode.
So, guys, we're back every Monday and Friday. To flame more Nintendo, Dark Souls, Ubisoft, and EA and stuff.
This is the flame Nintendo podcast.
It really is. We've said it for a while now. It really is. I really hope Nintendo proves me wrong. I mean, I want to play that new Pokemon real bad.
I have it, but I'm saving it for my trip. I have to drive.
I feel like we should say to the commenters, like, there's no reason to be mad at us if you disagree with us.
Hold on. It's like we were just like, man, fuck remasters. Fuck, they're so stupid. I really can't wait to play the new Pokemon. Yeah, I'm really excited.
No, I know you did that, and I was just about to point it out, but I decided to go the other direction.
Pokemon's immune to that. Pokemon's fucking... We go into Pokemon.
I don't believe you. I actually don't.
Knowing. No, we go in fucking knowing it's exactly the same, and we're okay with that.
You know what, though? For me, though, I'm not as passionate about remasters. I don't have a big problem with remasters. I do have a bit of a problem with the Final Fantasy thing, because that's a load of bullshit. They didn't do any work. They just ported it. That's functionally just, they booted up an emulator, and now here's a money-making machine.
It's the remasters that are like a year old.
That's also a big issue.
I mean, Sapphire, they came out, 10 years ago?
2002, yeah. I'd say, somewhere around there.
Yeah,
over a decade ago.
I don't have a problem with that. I mean, and they're also updating mechanics with the new Pokemon.
They put it into the X and Y engine and made it 3D and all this. And apparently, it has a bunch of new, still cool. People were telling me it's the best Pokemon to date.
In the third generation of Pokemon, remember too when it first came out, that was before they even had a delineation between physical attacks and special attacks.
We're going down the road of talking for another half an hour. I just want to point that out.
You're right. You're right. Yeah. Mondays and Fridays, we'll be back. I love you.
Sorry, bye, guys. Talk to you later.